Good morning, painters. This is number 23 in the world famous Monday Club water tutorials. Beam to you from lovely Marsh. Tony here, hope you are well, keeping warm. Had to put the heating on this morning. 8 degrees in August. Roll on September. Actually, the weather's very good at the moment. Right, here we have a dramatic seascape, a lighthouse in a storm. This will test our wet-in-wet abilities. Now, I've already painted this, so what follows is me starting from scratch and painting it in retrospect, so it's back to the future again. So I paint two movies and join them together. All clever stuff. Well, I haven't done it yet, so maybe not so clever. So, next thing you see, it'll be me on a blank sheet of paper. Let's see what happens. Okay, I'll make a start. I'll draw this in. Now, you've got the benefit of knowing what this will look like. I don't have that benefit because I haven't painted it yet. What I'm going to do is draw it and paint it to completion. Then this is all new to me. This is like back to the future, because I'll do a little movie at the end with the finished thing as a backdrop to my introduction. But I haven't done it yet. How weird. So, you'll know what it is already. It's a lighthouse. I'll talk through the techniques and stuff in the introduction movie. I'm just going to crack on now. Let's see what happens. So, let's see now. I've turned my palette round so you can see it better. Is that everything? Okay, there won't be any reflection either because I've shut the window blind. Okay, first thing, sea level. I'm thinking about a quarter way up, perhaps a bit more. There's a lot of surf flying around, so you may not see this, but I'll draw it in anyway. So the sea has got to be straight, it's got to be horizontal. That's just unarguable. Lighthouse position just off centre, size about that big, shape, they're all the same shape. Tapering conic section, whatever it is. Colour scheme, red and white. This is like the Beachy Head lighthouse, I'm imagining. It's red and white, so you can see it against the white cliffs. Ah, that's a bit of useless knowledge for you. So, let's see now. Okay. Looks all right. It's got a walkway around the light at the top. That's for the window cleaner, I should think. Now we're looking up at that. Perspective tells us we're looking from sea level up at that, so we can see underneath that. And these bands will change shape into a straight line at the bottom, something like this. So that's a straight line. I think it's got a little platform at the bottom. OK, Okay, and it's got, here's the light. And it's got a dome top to keep the weather out. And a little thing on top. It looks a bit off centre. I'll move this bit in a bit. Better. Okay. So this is my Chinese calligraphy brush. It's great if I could say it. Really useful, less than a tenner. Highly recommended. Turn my paints round, as I said, so you can see them. Quickly, neutral tint, which is a posh word for black. Payne's grey, very dark bluey grey. Sepia, extremely dark brown. Prussian blue. French ultramarine, my favourite blue. Cobalt blue and Windsor blue, which is intense bluey green. Cadmium yellow, cadmium lemon, not much of those left, but I won't be using them. Rose madder, violet, raw sienna, extremely useful colour. Light red, a powerful colour which is good with blue to form a interesting grey. Burnt sienna, also you can mix with blue for a grey, and that's really good skin tone on its own. And burnt umber. That's an invaluable earth colour, as is Naples yellow. That's a very dense, pale yellow. It's very similar to yellow ochre. Windsor green, it's a powerful green. Don't use it, it's a bit like Viridian. Use it with caution. Hooker's green, it's good at all round green if you can't be bothered mixing it. What's that? I don't know, another green. And cerulean blue, which is good for pale blue skies. And this is my bucket full of water. Right, so I'm just going to spray a bit of water on. Not too much. Have some of that. All standing by. So I'll do the lighthouse first. I know it's white, but it won't be snow white. That's fine. Bottom is concrete. And this platform is concrete. Okay. And decided that the bean shadow. The light is not lit. I've got some red lurking under my bucket somewhere. Let's see how this looks. Okay, I just turned you off because I realised I didn't have any red on my palette. That's Scarlet Lake. Put some on here. Let's go for it. Paint it in fully because I imagine it's quite a lot of spray kicking around. So I'm going to anticipate that. Leave some gaps. Could always paint it in with a solid white paint, but I'd rather not. Might have to, but we'll see. So I'm just strengthening this red up. Looks a bit puny. All the paint's running. Okay, that's okay for now. Get rid of this red paint now. Don't want any of that in the sky. Oh dear. A mess. Okay, the sky. It's a storm, so we've got a huge contrast in the sky. I'm mixing French ultramarine. Paint's grey. That looks okay. A bit more water. I'm going to spray some water on. See how that looks. Carry this through. Fairly haphazard application. Okay. I'm just doing this and I'm looking at this edge for inspiration. bit of burnt umber. And the sky over here. Just breaks in the cloud. It's nothing to do with the sea. Right. Water. So I'm just interfering with this edge ever so slightly. Leave a halo of pure white. Should I let the red dry, shouldn't I? If it stains the paper, you'll never get rid of it. That's about. All right. Moving quickly, I don't want this blue to dry completely. Winging this, I don't know if it'll work. Looks okay. So over here is the clouds in the distance. And underneath them will be a paler blue. Because it's better weather over there. Having a nightmare with this red. It's running all over the place. I might have to tidy this up with some gouache later, because it's It's refusing to go away. Remember that old ad on TV where they used a lighthouse to illustrate the power of their paint? Shouldn't be a very good advert, but it's running all over the place. It's also a little bit bright. I'm darkening it. I didn't think the red would be a problem anyway. Back to the sky. Some more water in there. To wet in wet. Okay. And out of the sea now. The sea will be very dark. Certainly on the horizon. Yep. Close to the horizon, there's be some wave action. Sound effects. A tad of green in there. We get some energy into the into these waves. See, I'm moving my arm as if it imparts energy. Just not used to my palette being this way around. use that pale blue I promised you. In the distance. Get some shadows under these waves. So, 26 minutes. I like to keep these movies under 30 minutes if possible. Right. Oops, sorry. To the sky. It's dry now. Take advantage of that. Preserve that little white patch. A bit fiddly, this is getting a bit fiddly. I think we might have to lose that. Jewelry's out on that one. Water. Because I want a soft edge. Not running wet, just slightly damp. better. Paint. Now this paper is show you what it is. It's on as Waterford, 100% cotton, and it's £140. Not means not smooth, but not rough either. And it's brilliant for this sort of work. As you've noticed, I can add water, it doesn't lift the what was already there, it just adds water. I think I'll put some of that cerulean blue in there, a bit of continuity. Okay, how's it looking? Looks alright, apart from the blasted lighthouse. So I need some lighthouse therapy. I'm forgetting what's on my brush. It wouldn't reflect any water, this, sky in this water. That's the last thing on its mind. Sorry if I've gone quiet. Let me know. Okay, done now. What I did was I let's see now. I firmed up on some detail. Added some shadows, especially under the waves, and it's done. So, yeah, quite happy with that and. Let's see, it looks okay actually. As in a portrait, that's why I signed it twice because I can't make my mind up. I think that looks better. Yeah, I think that looks. I think it looks better. I don't know. I'll decide later. Right. So, I hope you liked that, and I'll see you next week. Bye now.